friends. How are you? Can you wiggle your ears if you are ready to have some fun with me and Fitz today? Friends, today, Fitz and I are working on math. Fitz brought 3 pumpkins to play with. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3. Fitz, can you count your pumpkins? Fitz, 1, 2. And I brought 2 pumpkins. 1, 2. If Fitz has 3 pumpkins and I have 2 pumpkins, how many pumpkins do we have? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 5 pumpkins. Now, let's sing a counting song to learn more about our 5 pumpkins. How many pumpkins do you see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 little pumpkins. 5 little pumpkins sitting on the ground. The first one said, "We are orange and round." The second one said, "Some are short and small." The third one said, "Some are big and tall." The fourth one said, "We start as seeds and grow on a vine." The fifth one said, "We look mighty fine." Do you know how people use pumpkins? Some people like to cook with pumpkins. I like to use pumpkins to make pumpkin pie and pumpkin soup. And some people like to use pumpkins for decorations. Did you know that you can give a pumpkin a face? Or you can take a lot of pumpkins to make a bigger shape. Like this one is in the shape of the frog prince. Wow, that's a lot of pumpkins. Did you know that some pumpkins grow so big that a person can sit in it? That's right. When I lived in Germany, I saw people use really, really, really big pumpkins to make boats. Welcome to Miss Meghan's Science Lab. Today, we are going to take a closer look at pumpkins. What shape is a pumpkin? Is it a square? No, a pumpkin is a sphere. Can you say sphere? A sphere is like a ball. It is round and has no corners, so it can roll like this. Let's measure how big around my pumpkin is. I'm going to use a piece of yarn, scissors, and a pumpkin. I will wrap my yarn around the biggest part of my pumpkin. Right there in the middle. And now I'm going to cut where the 2 pieces of yarn meet. Here we go. is how big around my first pumpkin is. Let's try that again with another pumpkin. I'm going to try measuring this pumpkin next. Which pumpkin do you think will be bigger? I'm going to wrap my yarn around my pumpkin, just like I did the last time. And now I'm going to cut where the two pieces of yarn overlap. And this is how long my second pumpkin is. How do I know which pumpkin is bigger? Whichever piece of yarn is the longest means that that pumpkin is bigger. Which string is the longest? Pumpkin 1 or pumpkin 2? If you guessed pumpkin 1, then you are right. This is an awfully big pumpkin. I wonder if this pumpkin will sink or float in my tub of water. Do you have a guess? Can you give me a thumbs up if you think that the pumpkin will float in my tub of water? Or can you give me a thumbs down if you think the pumpkin will sink? Let's try it. Whoa! It may be hard to see, but this pumpkin is floating in the water. Look at that. Finally, the best part. Let's look at the different parts of the pumpkin. Let's start at the top. Do you see this brown part here? It looks kind of like a hat. This is called the stem. This is where the pumpkin grew on the vine, and when it was ready to be picked from the pumpkin patch, the farmer cut the vine and left this little piece here. It's called the stem. Can you say stem? The orange part all over the outside of the pumpkin is called the skin. Can you say skin? Just like your skin, the skin of the pumpkin protects what's inside. Now, look really close. Do you think that the skin of the pumpkin is smooth? No, the pumpkin skin is actually very bumpy. And it has these lines all the way around it from the stem to the bottom. Do you see those? Those are called ribs. Can you say ribs? Now, let's cut this pumpkin open to see what's inside. I cut my pumpkin open to see what is inside. Let's have a closer look. Do you see this yellow-orange part between the skin and the middle? This part is called the pulp. Can you say pulp? The pulp is what people use to make pumpkin pies or pumpkin soups. This is the part of the pumpkin that's very good to eat. And now look all the way in the middle of the pumpkin. Do you see all of those seeds? Lots of people like to roast pumpkin seeds to eat as a snack. But you can also take a pumpkin seed to plant in your garden to make your very own pumpkin. Did you know that every pumpkin that you see, the really, really big ones and the really, really small ones, all start as a seed, just like that? Well, now that I have cut my pumpkin open, I think I will scoop out the inside to roast the seeds and roast this pulp to make a yummy pumpkin pie. Now you know all the parts of the pumpkin. Let's sing a song to help you remember what they are. Little pumpkin on the ground, your stem is like a hat, your skin turned orange as you sat on the vine, little pumpkin, what's inside? What's inside? Seeds and pulp that we can eat. Turn them into tasty treats like pumpkin pie. Good job. Let's sing it one more time. Little pumpkin, on the ground, your stem is like a hat. Your skin turned orange as you sat on the vine, little pumpkin, what's inside, seeds and pulp that we can eat, turn them into tasty treats like pumpkin pie. Would you like to share books with your family about pumpkins, or maybe learn a new way to cook with pumpkins? Please visit hclibrary.org to search the library's catalog for some of my favorites. You can use your library card to place requests for these books or other books and pick them up from your local Howard County Library System branch with contactless pickup. Some books are available for you to borrow on your Kindle, too. For a fun nonfiction book with photographs of all kinds of growing pumpkins, I suggest Pumpkin by Jackie Lee. In Pumpkin Day by Candace Ransom, you can visit the pumpkin patch with a young boy and his family. I Spy a Pumpkin by Jean Marzallo is filled with picture puzzles and riddles. Also, be sure to look at some of the other great I Spy books. Pumpkin Pumpkin by Jean Titherington follows the life cycle of a pumpkin. Purely Pumpkin by Allison Day offers over 100 recipes to try using fall's favorite ingredient, pumpkins. Before I go, I'd like to share one more experiment with you. Let's see how far we can throw this pumpkin using my catapults. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3.
and it's still rolling.
Did you have fun with me and Fitz today? We worked on a math problem together and counted pumpkins, and then we did a couple of experiments with pumpkins. I hope this week you will try counting something with your family or take a walk to enjoy the beautiful colors of fall. Until next time, stay safe and well. Fitz and I will see you again soon.